edition 100. This is number 80. The plate's wearing, so it's a bit thinner. You can just about see the cross hatching at the bottom of the picture and the distance. It's all like the best pictures summing up what it's really like. You've got a stone wall, you've got the trees amongst the fields, a cow grazing on its own there, and a barn in the distance, and the rounded glacial hill. And then you have the bubbling clouds, because it's in quite a wet, windy valley, this. Then you have on the left Arthur, leaning on, they all had sticks, and they all needed their sticks for the sheep and the sheep dog, and they'd spread their arms out, and the stick would be another 4 foot, 5 foot even. And that made the sheep keep in. There's one thing that cows and sheep don't like, it's a stick. One farmer around here went into a field with it, across the field with his stick, and the bull would not even look at him. Once he went without his stick, the bull nearly got him. The farmers all had flat hats in those days. A wry sense of humour. Very wry sense of humour. And the pace of life was so different, even in 1976 or 7. Welly boots. I remember they posed in welly boots, and I always thought, why are they wearing those thick boots? Coats. One tall, they're all like this. And I did it from a sculpture that I made, and they were quite tall, about 15 inches high, on a piece of, with armature and everything, a girl sculptress who I'd grown up with. She helped me setting up the armatures, then went away for a month, and then I did the sculptures. And her father made the sticks in the sculpture, and I should have brought it along and put it on the table in this gallery in Muker, but I didn't. So that's that one. It's an 18 inch square picture, and it's in black and white, and I don't often do that, do I? No, I don't often do them anymore. Usually my stuff is the colour. That's what I am, a colourist. But I'm quite proud of that. It's quite geometric. If I point things out, I want it straight, straight, curve. There are a few things. You have to play a bit, you know. But they're quite soft. That's how they are when they talk. Mouth's not, doesn't matter if it's not very well drawn. The grin is there, the white eyebrows on this man here. They are how you see them now. You can just imagine them bursting into activity, can't you? This one shouting at the old heifers, not going the right way. This one being a bit of a dad, more a dandy, and light-headed. Always had a, what do they call them? Pipe in his mouth. Now his son's a sheep dealer, and his son bets on horses and farms a bit in Worton Hall. This one, well, he had three daughters, so they all got married. If I did it again now, I'd make the stones this size rather than that size. It's a bit thin, the stone. I'd probably have the barn door. That could have been it, the barn door there. Just high enough to lob the hay in. God, I did a lot of that once. Did you, Oliver?
No.
Oh my goodness, did I do a lot. Nowadays they have everything, we can't believe it, you know. Sort of escalators, and you put it at the bottom, and up there you go. That's that one. It does feel like summer, although, yeah, and this, with the sculpture, of course, you can work out the shadows better, you know, you can actually shine an angle poised light at it, and you get it exactly right, I presume. Yes, it must have been this side. So there's the shadow there, white hair. And I discovered that Poussin did exactly the same when he painted his history pictures. Say you're dancing around the golden calf. You know, he just put his women up like that, with a little bit of plasticine, and so did Claude, who lived at the same time in Rome, in just after the Renaissance, 1650. And that's what they did, to muck around with the light and get it absolutely right. They had candles, of course, so they Must have been nice soft light. That's probably why they did so many evening pictures of her. They all look very soft. Brilliant pictures. I suppose light and shade is what I like to do. If you take the picture right next to it, you can, the colour one. I did that for Lady Diana Britton, for her husband's funeral work. And you've got the light in the distance with a cherry tree or an ash tree giving a bit of light. So you're being forced into there. There's a rainbow one side and a shaft of light the other, and then one of my famous skies, which I like doing. But someone said, you've just done teddy bears in the sky, so that put me off a bit. And that's Penn Hill, where you've got the shadow there. And that was what turned me on when I saw it in real life. The fact that the hill was solid and yet looked like a very light, like a wave, you know. And this sort of cool colour on the wood. I notice all the colours in real life. I'm yawning a lot because I haven't slept for a long time, but working. Yes, that may have not been. Does that worry you, the plovers tumbling?
They tumble in the wind, though, don't they? They play in the wind.
They certainly do. Oh, yeah, they love flying. It's not often a bird. Well, actually, it is often a bird, especially swallows and stuff, that like to just do acrobatics for the sake of it. Plovers, certainly. I once worked out how plovers actually turned by making a card drawing and then doing it 30 times, moving it slightly. And then when I got the next photograph, I saw that the plover was turned, so I clicked that and I did the same 30 of those. I numbered them and then I knew that when I got to 31, that was the second stage of the tumble. Then I throwed away 29 from each of them, literally, and I ended up with 10. I could do that. I can't show it you here, it's gone.
That's the Ye Will Rise?
Mm-hmm.
Ye Will Rise, or the one with the plovers on?
I worked it out how the plovers fall and turn over at the same time. They do a very quick twitch, but my publisher actually did a naughty thing and he photosensitized a 10-foot by 4-foot bathroom curtain that goes up and down. And had a photograph of that etching put on. I quite like that. Sorry, it's lack of sleep, but that one certainly is. Do you like that one, honey?
Yes.
I'll bear in mind. So there we go. So these are the Wenstall ones, the big one above, of the Penn Hill. And it does go like that in the summer evening when the light's low. And you get blue shadows going across and then more blueness where the trees are. And it was a Suffolk tub, which probably didn't go down very well in the Dales, because Suffolk were very popular. I think they're with Swale Dales. Anyway, on we go. There are Roman villas under some of these fields, you know. It's very busy with Romans, you know. Almost miniature cities, some of these places around Wensley. I know that Lord Bolton was furious. I happened to be with him for some reason. And he said, they just ploughed up a field and there's a villa below. So there's the moon. I've always adored the moon. The white moon there. And I always like light on clouds. However, I will say this here and now that it wasn't quite as richly coloured as I'd wanted it, this one. It's a land where sheep may safely graze. Well, the middle one there, Hayfield and Hawthorns, is a difficult one because you've got Elderflower and the Hayfields out at the same time. And a dry riverbank there. I quite like the depth of the black. It's always tempting to go blacker than the real black. So I may have done that. But the light, it's a low evening light, and it's clipping the. Oh, that's quite good, you know, got a double arc there. And then that just coming through, I should have followed, I think I probably did, by hand painting those yellow daisies. There were loads of daisies in that field. And this is how the rocks are, and I wondered how to do them. I just deep bit a plate, drilled it off, threw an actinide here and there, and coloured it, and it's exactly like the limestone that comes through to make what we call bony land. So there we are. It's better than I thought, some of these etchings, you know. Always have straight lines in pictures. You can't go wrong with the barn and that one. But there's a straight line in the cloud, in a way. You've got the curve, so have a straight line. You've got waffly old shapes at the edges of elders, so have a bit of a cliff there with the dark ones. You can muck around. I've had a bit of luck with that one, because I had the cliff, which I pruned a bit of the hawthorn. Yes, that's quite nice. There's more I can do to that one nowadays. Now, you like this one down here, the little one.
The plovers, yeah. That's
more plovers, more plovers. Apposite viaduct, just scratch into the plate accurately. You don't normally scratch with etching, you etch. This one, I just got a bare piece of metal, made it rather darker. I'd scratched. And it's called a dry point because you haven't got anything wet on it. And so I did the viaduct, a bit of the grasses, a bit of the stone wall, the post, the bird, and all that very quickly, very easily. And then I just got another plate and I'd put an aquatint. Or I didn't even do that, I just rubbed in blue. I rubbed in blue, I rubbed in orange, and that's all, and blue up there. And then I put a roller of yellow over, quite rich down here, and not so bad up there, and then got a baby bud and wiped out the grey on that thing there. I don't know how I kept the grey, I must have wiped out a bit of the thing as well. It looks complicated, but it's an easier one to do. I must print more of those, tell my assistant. Right, the last three in this section are the seasons. I did four of the seasons. We're talking about 1977. Ages. I'd only lived at the house for 2 years, but it needed a lot of bills. And there we go. In those days, if you got a builder, you know, you were very lucky and you could go on forever getting things done. I didn't want to build, so I had to pay for them. My dog was Winnie, who came with me from cross between a sheepdog and a Labrador. Wonderful dog, absolutely wonderful. The cross breeds are sometimes so intelligent and loving, and a hare, long legs. It's done on the soft ground, it's a bit different. Anyway, when you're looking up Dale over Askrig and Hawes, typical lights, I was even then doing lights in the cloud because that's what it's like. And the one next to it is, again, sheep in a field. Slightly, I was going to say slightly, I shouldn't say it really, but it's slightly too blue. The farmer just dollops it on, you know. It can be red or black. We have red, black and blue in our part. Never green, as far as I can see, but you put dew blobs. The yellow on the bottom is where they put on the round, the yellow.
I have seen yellow
marks on sheep. Well, there we go. Not very often, but you do. And probably green. It's like they're putting these big dairy, what do you call them, creamery bales, you know, advertising.
Yeah.
And some of them are purple. Well, some of the farmers around here use purple bin, bloody great bin bags to bag up their silo. They're getting a bit of amusing. Typical Dales.
But the plover again.
Yes, two plovers. One somewhere down here. There he is. And one there. I had to hand paint the white because you... Do you know, I've got a feeling this is only one plate with a roller of yellow.
And Penhill in the background.
Penhill in the background and leading up to Attleborough. The,
yeah.
What do you call it? The flat top Cape Town stuff. Cape Table Mountain.
Yeah.
That's... Oh, it was the the bump or something. It was called something else. I'll come to me. But that's a that's a perfect glacial terminal moraine where the glacier retreats, and it leaves the sand, basically sand and rock, a bit of rock, as it goes, and then the water washes round the rocks and keeps adding more silt till you've got a hillock. The bump, I think it was called the bump. 1895, it planted the Scots pines on top. Anyway, those are Mr. Willie Metcalfe, sheep, and his son now farms. And then, grandson, rather. And a roller of yellow, very thick there and pale. So that's good. And the final one is an ancient hawthorn that has collapsed. It's so ancient, that bit's come off, and that to there. And when I last went, all that was there was that and about 2 inches. I think someone had come with a chainsaw to make sure it was dead. As I said, there's a shrike, a mouse stuck in the branch, the third one down from the top. With a shrike is just like a merlin, a little bird, little hawk, and they just use the tree as their larder and plonk them down. Castle Bolton just lit up, and Attleborough in the distance was like a shock of white. I'm surprised no one's asked me, have I made a mistake? No. Anyway, there we are, hawthorn. That must have been 400 years old. In the time of Richard III, not Richard I, 1690. It's quite easy to print. Is that me? No. So there we go.
That's the Wensleydale etchings.
That's it.
And it was verse and etchings from the book.
Wensleydale. Etchings and verse. I called it verse, but you put poetry. They said, that's not poetry, it's rubbish. Well, I'll call it verse then.